to all my princesses out there, this is Jess Marie, aka Blondie Jones. But I am not blonde today, as you can see. I do have my natural hair up. I just pinned it up in a bun really quick and put a really pretty flower. I thought I'd do some pink for Valentine's Day. But this is a different kind of video than usual. It's not about makeup. It's not about wigs or anything like that. I just wanted to come on and talk about my top five favorite Valentine's Day movies to watch. Valentine's Day is one of the sweetest and very special holidays. I love it so much, and I'm especially excited about this year because I get to spend it with my husband. And as you guys know, we are newlyweds. We got married in September, so I'm really excited to find out what kind of surprises are in store for Valentine's Day. So anyway, let's just go ahead and get into this really, really quickly. So my first, which would be considered number five, favorite Valentine's Day movie to watch is 27 Dresses. 27 Dresses is about Katherine Heigl, and she is she's a secretary for a company, and she is always a bridesmaid, never a bride. So her journey going through that, trying to find the right one and trying to find love, she's always a bridesmaid in someone else's wedding. She's always planning someone else's wedding, but she never finds the right one. So she goes the journey of this movie of figuring out who the one is and finding her true love. So that's number five on my list. Number four on my list is Simply Irresistible. I'm a huge Sarah Michelle Gellar fan. I absolutely positively love her. She's one of my favorite actresses, all because of Buffy the Vampire Slayer. You guys may not know this, but I'm a huge Buffy the Vampire Slayer fan. I have all seven seasons of Buffy the Vampire Slayer, literally. So Sarah Michelle Gellar is one of my favorite movies. She's actually a witch in this movie, and the way her power works is she puts her emotions through her food, and her power is basically food, to make food luxurious and make food beautiful. So whatever emotion that she's feeling, it goes into her food, and she falls in love in the process. And she kind of puts a spell on the guy without knowing she puts a spell on the guy for him to fall in love with her and things of that nature. But it's a really, really good movie. It's a really good love story. So that's number four on my list. This one was hard because there's so many good movies out there. Number three is The Wedding Singer. My best friend Clarice and I, when we were kids, we used to go see this movie over and over and over again in the 90s. It was like the best movie, and it's still a really, really good love story classic. Adam Sandler is a wedding singer. And Drew Barrymore is a waitress, and she's actually engaged to be married, but they fall in love in the process, and all kinds of crazy things happen. This is a comedy also, but it's really, really good, and it's really, really funny. So if you guys have not seen The Wedding Singer, make sure you see that, but you may have because it's been out for a while. That's number three on my list. Number two on my list is Maid in Manhattan. I am a big Jennifer Lopez fan. I mean, who doesn't love J-Lo, right? But this is my second choice. This was hard because I was torn between this one and the one that I chose for number one, because I absolutely positively love her dress that she wore to the ball. Basically, Maid in Manhattan is she is a maid that works in a luxury hotel in New York City, and she falls in love and she meets the senator, I believe, and he mistakes her for a socialite, a woman of wealth and things of that nature. And then they fall in love, and, you know, she has to reveal to him who she really is. You guys have probably seen it. It's been out for a while. But Maid in Manhattan is definitely one of my top favorites. So this is number two. My all-time favorite girly, mushy, love Valentine's Day film, my number one is A Walk to Remember. I don't know if you guys have seen this, but it has Mandy Moore and Shane West. This is a really, really cute, adorable, just mushy love movie. And I'm such a girly girl. I always tell you guys that. But it's really good. It's sad. It's kind of sad. It's not terribly sad, but it's a really, really good, touching movie. And I think it's for people of all ages, and it teaches you that young people can love just as strong as people that are in their prime, or that true love has no age or anything like that, and love can change you. And basically he's a bad boy and she's a good church going girl, and they didn't really like each other. They pretty much, his friends would pick on her because he was the popular guy in school and things of that nature, and he ends up falling in love with her, and they come together and they spend, you know, a lot of time together, and they fall madly in love with one another. And then, you know, they go through some obstacles like regular couples do. And then you find out later on that she has leukemia, and he chooses to stay with her. He chooses to stay by her side, and they get married, and, you know, she unfortunately passes. But it's a really, really good movie. Really, really good acting, really, really good characters. So this is my number one Valentine's Day video. I love it so much. And it, like I said, it's kind of sad, but it's not that sad. So it's not really, really heavy. It has a positive, uplifting feeling at the end of the film. It lets you know that love can change you. And so, like I said, I just wanted to come on here really quickly and talk about my top five favorite Valentine's Day movies. And I'm really excited about Valentine's Day. I can't wait to spend it with my husband. And I hope you guys have a fantabulous, I always say fantabulous. I hope you guys have a fantastic Valentine's Day. And you spend it with the ones that you love. And if not, all you single guys out there, you do your thing, honey. You spend Valentine's Day doing you, whether you're getting a medi-pedi or you're going to dinner with friends or you're going to the movies. You guys have a good one too. And self-love, love yourself, and you know, splurge on yourself. There's nothing wrong with that. Buy yourself some chocolates or some balloons or something like that. And all you guys out there that have someone to love, make sure you hold them tight and you squeeze them and you show them how much you love them, and you show them that you appreciate them, because you never know when the moment may be your last moment. So every day, just treasure that and share this Valentine's Day with the ones that you love, family, friends, whoever it may be. And I wish you guys the best. I hope you guys are staying safe and you have a wonderful Valentine's Day. And thank you to all my new subscribers for subscribing to my channel. I really appreciate all the love. I hope you guys keep on coming and keep the love coming and keep coming back. And I'll most definitely continue to do all different types of videos. And I hope you guys have a happy Valentine's Day. And I'll see my royals soon, okay? Bye.
'Cause you say sometimes I wanna slap you on your whole face.